Self-help and sustainability have remained as the hallmark of our support. We take you through a journey into the world of our beneficiaries who have been transformed from victims to survivors. Their stories reflect the undying human spirit that rises every time it falls. The dual destruction rendered many people homeless. The process of sheltering them in temporary accommodation, later providing them with semi-permanent housing, and finally giving them permanent houses was seen as a very positive experience. In some cases, entire villages have been recreated into model villages. Having been displaced multiple times, Arumugam returned to rebuild his life. He stayed in a hut and tried agriculture. He first got a water pump that helped him secure his living. Later, he was also given a house. Now he says,
அவங்க செஞ்ச உதவி காலத்துல இப்படி ஒரு வீட்டுல இருக்கணும், இல்லாட்டி நாங்க இந்த வீட்டுல தான் இருக்கணும். அவங்க உதவி செஞ்சாங்க, நாங்க ஓடி ஓடி தான் இல்லாம போய் அப்ப இன்னும் ஓடிக்கிட்டு இருந்தா நம்மளோட பிள்ளைன்ற வாழ்க்கை என்ன வருது? அப்ப பிறந்த இந்த மண்ணில் அதுல சாகணும்னா சாகும், பரவாயில்ல நம்ம குடும்பத்தோட இருப்போம் அப்படின்னு நாங்க இருந்தோம். இந்த வீடு இருக்கிறனால தாங்க நாங்க இப்ப இந்த வீட்டை விட்டு போகாம இருக்கிறோம். இப்ப இந்த மாதிரி வீடுனா விட்டுட்டு போயிருவாங்க, போன முறை விட்டு போன மாதிரி நாங்கள் விட்டு தான் போவோம். இனி கஷ்டப்பட்டோம், இனி இனி வீடு இருக்கிறது நல்லதா போச்சு.
දුන්නට මං අසරණ වෙලා මං කවුරුත් කිසිම ආයතනයකින්වත් මේ වගේ උදව්වක් නැහැ. මං කන්න මට ජීවත් වෙන්නවත් ක්‍රමයක් කුමුරක් පිටියක් කරගන්න නැහැ. මේ නිසා ඔබලාත් සියලු දෙනාටම පින් සිද්ධ වෙන්න මං කියනවා.
For those who returned home, it was important for them to have a sustainable life. Small initiatives such as providing seeds, farming implements, and agro-education has taken people a long way. Arumugam and Chellamma have benefited from this scheme. Presently, they grow their own vegetables and over 15 varieties of pulses. With this, they are able to support themselves as well as the other families that depend on them. Restoring livelihood to the vulnerable sections has been a story of success. Meenambal, a widow, lost all her belongings to the tsunami. In her forlorn state, she was given a small grant of Rs 20,000 to restart her life selling vegetables. She now makes enough money to sustain herself, to educate her children, and to lead a decent life. She says, "If not for this time, I can't imagine what I would have done." Selvi lost her husband to the conflict. He was shot in a crossfire. Her world fell apart after his death. Living with her elderly parents, she was not sure what to do. She even thought of killing herself with her son. the timely counseling and financial aid helped her to set up a small business, which facilitated her to sustain herself. Mangadu, one of the most poverty-stricken villages, was identified for intervention. Mr. Suri Kumar, a present staff member of OFFER, along with his family, were homeless. His father, a carpenter, had no tools to start his work. They were provided a house and tools to work with. He now uses his tools to rebuild his house and also goes to the neighboring villages using his tools to earn a livelihood.
நேரம் சும்மா கஷ்டப்பட்டு இருந்த ஆட்களுக்கு இப்படி ஒரு உதவியை செய்த உடனே அவங்களுக்கும் ஒரு முன்னேற்றத்தை கொண்டாடுது. இன்னும் அதிலிருந்து ஊக்குவிப்பு வருகிறது.
Having lived as a refugee in India from 1990 to 2003, Sarojini returned to Sri Lanka. When she was trying to start a new home, she was looking for a way to meet her daily expenses. The volunteers from OFFER advised her to initiate a poultry farm. She took the advice and also the financial assistance. This has made a visible change in her life. She now owns over 50 chickens and uses them to help her maintain herself and her family.
OFFER. இதல 20000 ரூபாய் கொடுத்தாங்க. நாங்களும் கொஞ்சம் காசு போட்டு செய்வோம். ரெண்டு வருஷமா செய்வோம். 10000 இந்த நான் கிடைக்கும் 45 நாளைக்குல.
Women, especially widows, who were found to be the most vulnerable, are formed into self-help groups. They save and take care of their daily life with the money they have. They have also started a rental facility to rent out chairs, tables, and other utensils to make a profit. This fetches them enough income to lead an independent life. Community-based peace-building activities are organized in many villages. Staff who are specially trained in peace-building and conflict transformation bring together the Sinhala, Tamil and Muslim communities to interact, learn, work and live together in harmony. Despite the ongoing protracted conflict, people come together for these programs. Enable quality education, the tsunami-affected schools were supported with infrastructure facilities such as labs, classrooms, notebooks, and other relief materials.
Over then, when they will be part of the model, pretty a copy of the angle, the pool would have put the matamilam angle in the cutter angle at the mailum chilla for cutter angle. உருவாக்கி தரதுக்கும் அவங்கள் நம்மகிட்ட சொல்லியிருக்கிறாங்க. சுனாமியால் இந்த பிரதேசம் கூடுதலாக பாதிக்கப்பட்டது. எங்களோட பாடசாலை மாணவர்களே ஒரு 5 பேர் செத்துருக்கிறாங்க. கிராமத்தில் உள்ளவர்கள் கூடுதலாக இறந்திருக்கிறார்கள்.
The war and the killer waves of the tsunami took scores of children with them. Much of this could have been prevented if children were trained in disaster preparedness. As a preventive measure, the school students are now specially trained in disaster risk reduction drills to seek safety and save their lives along with others.